Hello, friends. Our story today will show us that it is always necessary to pay attention to people who are around us. And it does not matter at all whether you personally know them or not. It can be a neighbor you see every morning while jogging, or even a homeless person. Each of us may have difficulties in life, and this is only natural. The most important thing is to remain kind in every situation, no matter what. After all, everyone knows that it is darkest before the dawn. Our hero today is a 25-year-old man named Greg Smith from Orlando, Florida. He is an ordinary American person who lives like everyone else. He's a successful fitness trainer and sales manager, a family man, and a loving husband with two sons. Like most people these days, he rushes to work every morning. His office is located in the center of Orlando, and since the place is crowded, you can often find homeless people there. And it usually happens that every morning when homeless people see a respectably dressed young man, they always beg for money. Sometimes Greg could give a few bucks, and sometimes he just passes by. I think many people do this. But he was always surprised by a woman that every time she saw Greg only smiled at him and wished him a good morning and a good day. She never asked for anything like all the other beggars did. As he told later on, "I just felt warmer in my heart when I heard these words every morning." This went on for several months. Every morning, Greg would rush to work, and every morning, as scheduled, he received some positive energy from the woman. This probably would have continued, but one time on his way to work, he decided to stop by the woman and talk to her. The woman's name was Amy Jo. She turned out to be a kind and interesting conversationalist. She was not rude at all, like many people who lived in the street. Of course, he gave a few dollars to his new friend, and although she refused at first, she finally took it. The next day, returning from work in the evening, Greg decided to visit Amy again, and when he approached her during a conversation, he found out that with the money she got yesterday, she bought a magazine and a book. So, day after day, he began to visit the homeless woman. He even brought her some food to her each time, but he wanted to do something more for her. After some time, at lunchtime, Greg went up to Amy and offered to keep her company and to have lunch at a nearby cafe. When they were at the table, Greg suggested that the woman should choose anything from the menu that she wanted, and he was greatly struck by her answer, "I cannot read." At first, he thought that maybe she just didn't want to burden him with her choice. Perhaps she would order something more expensive than he could afford. But actually, it is hard to believe, but Amy really could not read or write. Then Greg realized that this is why she spent her money on books and magazines. She just wanted to learn how to do this simple thing. Well, as the young man learned her story, he realized that he had to help. He found out that Amy grew up without parents. All of her childhood, she went from shelter to shelter, and she was never able to master the elementary school curriculum. Sometime later, when she was old enough to get a job, she applied to various low-paying jobs, but every time she was refused as soon as they found out that she could not read or write. So she ended up in the street. Greg was most surprised not by the fact that his new friend was illiterate, but by the fact that there are so many homeless people who can read, but they do not try to change their lives for the better. And most of them are strong men who could find some kind of physical work. And here is just a woman who dreams of building her own life and changing it for the better. Then, without thinking twice, Greg decided to teach Amy how to read. For a long time since, he taught the woman how to read, turning into a strict and responsible teacher. Amy was a grateful and intelligent student who studied quickly. Every Tuesday for several months, the fitness trainer and the homeless woman talked in a cafe, shared various life stories, and of course, did the homework. Soon, she learned how to read, but still she was not completely confident in herself, so Greg introduced a new lesson in their pastime. Every Tuesday, he took a new book from the library, brought it to the cafe, and read it with Amy. In addition, some weeks later, Greg often began to bring his wife and children to the lessons, and they all had a great time. The man and his wife taught Amy, and the children saw a good example of how you could help people so that later they themselves could achieve what they want from life. Of course, at first, the cafe staff did not like the cafe visitor of a homeless woman, but over time, they even began to offer good discounts for them, and sometimes they treated them at the expense of the cafe. And very soon, all the work that Greg did had success. Amy completely left the street. After the woman learned how to read, Greg paid for her stay for a month in a comfortable hotel. It was so touching for Amy that she even cried, because before, no one had done anything like this for her. And here, for half a year, the man and his family spent time and money in order to help her so much. But the story does not end here. Smith not only paid for housing, but he also started a GoFundMe page. With its help, several thousand dollars were collected, which was enough for several weeks. By the way, this story happened just a few years ago, and since then, a lot of things have changed. Amy got a job and has been self-supporting. Greg and his friends helped the woman to get permanent housing. Greg and his family made friends with Amy, and they still meet every week, but either at home or attending various events. The man shared his experience on his Facebook page, hoping that the story would inspire someone else, and that they will do similar good deeds in the same way. The more people that will help each other, the better our world will become. The most important thing is that Greg does not consider his act to be heroic at all, and he does not think that he's done anything particularly wonderful. It was just normal for him, and he says about his gesture, "My parents taught me to help people in need. That is why I must also teach my children to do like this." Well, looking at Greg, his family, and grateful Amy, you will certainly begin to understand that kindness still exists in the world, and it is all around us, and it exists not only in movies and books. And every one of us can save someone else's life, because sometimes it's only one gesture that is enough for this. Friends, what do you think about the young man's deed? Was it worth doing? Be sure to write your opinion in the comments. Well, that is all for today. Bye!